بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My brothers and sisters in Islam, the final moments in this life are going to be the most difficult and intense moments we will ever experience in our life. Much more difficult and much more intense than any hardship we have ever gone through in our lives, and certainly much more difficult than what we are living and going through currently today as we experience this pandemic of the virus. My brothers and sisters in Islam, these are the moments in which a person would begin to feel the slow beating of his heart, and this is the moment in which a person begins to experience difficulty inhaling and exhaling as the soul is collected from the body and being prepared to leave this body and going to another world. Allahu A'lam how the experience and how the feeling is then when a person is transitioning from this worldly life to the hereafter. However, as believers, as Muslims, we should always be prepared and ready for this moment, the moment in which we die and ultimately end up meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters in Islam, As-Salaf rahimahumullah, it was said that if you were to tell one of them, or if one of them was to be told that tomorrow you will die, they would respond with absolutely nothing. Nothing in their life would change. Nothing in their daily and weekly routine would change. And what we learn from this is because they were always ready to die. Unlike you and I, if we were told that we are going to die tomorrow, how much panic would settle in our heart? How much panic would happen in our lives? What would we rush to think about? How many things are we going to have to change in our life? What tawbah are we going to rush to? What fiqh is seeking Allah's forgiveness are we going to rush to? How much change are we going to do in that one day? As-Salaf rahimahumullah, if they were told that they will die tomorrow, they will change nothing at all because they were always prepared and ready for death. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before his prayers, sometimes he used to say, before he began Allahu Akbar, he used to say, Sallu salata muwaddi'. He used to say to the companions, pray a farewell prayer. Ya'ani, pray this prayer as though you are farewelling this dunya right after it. Allahu Akbar. This is the efforts in how Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to always encourage his sahaba to be prepared for death. Pray as though this is your last prayer. فالصحابة رضي الله عنهم would pray behind the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم. And that wasn't their last prayer. They will pray many more after that. However, the attitude that this is their last prayer was always present in their heart for every salat. Allahu Akbar. That's the same attitude you and I were supposed to have. At least every time before you come to pray, think and keep this in your mind throughout the entire salat, that this could possibly be your last salat on earth. How would you want it to be? Which kind of salat would you want to end your life with? This is the mentality and the attitude you're supposed to be praying every single salat so that you're always preparing for death. Let me share with you, my brothers and sisters in Islam, three practical things that you and I can do during the day and during the night that bi'idhnillahi ta'ala will always prepare us for death no matter when we die. The first of them is the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that was narrated by Abu Umam al-Bahili radiyallahu anhu. And the hadith is authenticated by Al-Imam Ibn Hibban rahimahullah and others, in which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من قرأ آية الكرسي دبر كل صلاة مكتوبة لم يمنعه من دخول الجنة إلا الموت. That whoever reads آية الكرسي, الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم, whoever reads this ayah after every obligatory prayer, then nothing prevents him from entering the paradise other than death. Yani, in other words, the only thing that is preventing you from entering the paradise is the fact that you're still alive. The moment you die, you enter the paradise. Allahu Akbar, five opportunities every single day to renew your guaranteed position bi-idhnillah in the paradise. The second method and the second way, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that whoever recites Sayyidul Istighfar, which is Allahumma anta rabbi la ilaha illa ant khalaqtani wa ana abduk wa ana ala ahdika wa wa'dika mastata't a'udhu bika min sharri ma sana't abu'u laka bi ni'matika alayya wa abu'u bi dhanbi faghfir li fa innahu la yaghfiru adh-dhunuba illa ant. Whoever says this dhikr once in the morning and once in the afternoon, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, anyone who says it in the morning and he is certain about its meaning and he dies before the afternoon, he enters the paradise. Ready. A person is ready for death if he says this in the morning. And whoever says it in the afternoon and he's certain in the meanings of this dhikr, then if he was to die before the morning, he enters the paradise. Allahu Akbar, 24/7. He is ready for death, such a person that recites this dhikr. And a third preparation for death, and this is the final one I share with you. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, as in the hadith of Al-Bara' ibn Azib radiyallahu anhu, Al-Hadith al-Sahih, found in Sahih al-Bukhari, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, whoever says before they sleep, Allahumma aslamtu nafsi ilayk, ووجهت وجهي إليك وفوضت أمري إليك وألجأت ظهري إليك رغبة ورهبة إليك لا ملجأ ولا منجى منك إلا إليك آمنت بكتابك الذي أنزلت وبنبيك الذي أرسلت. Whoever says this dhikr just before he sleeps, making the dhikr of Allah the last mention on his tongue before he sleeps, and he dies during his sleep, مات على الفطرة, he dies upon الفطرة, he dies upon purity, he dies upon Iman, upon Islam, بإذن الله. That's like a way, that's a method in how you always remain prepared to enter the paradise and prepared for death. For my brothers and sisters in Islam, inshallah, in upcoming videos, I will share with you these three adhkar and their intricate meaning, detailed meaning. What do they refer to? How do they make our lives easier? What do they mean so that we're always able to say them? Because when you know what they mean, you're always motivated to say them and you will never forget them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to always keep us ready for death, for that moment in which we are going to meet Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we ask Allah azza wa jal to give us the ability, to always give us the ability that we mention Him subhanahu wa ta'ala and always keep Him on our minds and in our hearts and in our soul. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.